Okay, so if you do have a yoga block, guys, like I said, grab a yoga block and a mat. You're definitely going to want something to pad up your knees. Yeah, and then let's start down on the ground. So just have the yoga block next to you or have it nearby because you'll be needing it in a few moments. But first, let's just come down and we're going to start with some breath work on the ground. So go ahead, lay down flat on your back. Bring your feet hips width distance flat on the floor. You can take a moment to maybe scrunch the toes, release them, splay them open, and then set your toes down on the ground. Just place your hands on the side of your rib cage, and we're going to begin with some breath work here, trying to develop as expansive of a breath pattern as we can. So we really want to think about our breath and our diaphragm becoming more three-dimensional rather than just breathing in and out and letting our stomach inflate. We're going to try to really inflate into the sides of the rib cage and into the back body. So try to think of filling up the space back here into your mat as you inhale, and everything around your torso basically is inflating. If you can imagine that you have a little balloon inside of you, and as you breathe in, the balloon is going to inflate. And then as you breathe out, the balloon deflates three-dimensionally as well. Okay. So we're going to start with a three-count breath. Inhaling for three and exhaling for three, imagining that balloon in the belly and making it as expansive as possible. So go ahead and exhale all the air out of your lungs. And then you're going to inhale for one, two, three. Exhale for three, two, one. Inhale for one, two, three. Exhale for three, two, one. Inhale for one, two, three. Exhale, three, two, one. Inhale for one, two, three. Exhale, three, two, one. Continue with that rhythm of your breath for another few rounds. And as you breathe in, notice how the hands and the rib cage can open up to the sides. And as you breathe out for three, your rib cage and your hands pull down and in, bringing your fingers closer together on your stomach. So again, inhale, one, two, three. Exhale, three, two, one. Let's do two more rounds. Inhale, one, two, three. Exhale, three, two, one. Inhale, one, two, three. Exhale, three, two, one. Good. And now we're going to place one hand low on the belly, on your lower abdominals, and the other hand is going to be up right at the bottom of your sternum or right at the top of your rib cage. So we're going to try to encourage a two-part inhale, breathing down into our bottom hand first, then carry the inhale up into your top hand, and then we'll exhale both hands together. So here we go. Go ahead, exhale all the air out of your lungs. And now inhale, breathe down. Carry the breath up as you continue to inhale into your top hand. And exhale, both hands together, pulling everything in. Again, inhale, breath goes low. Carry the inhale up. and out with both hands. Let's do that just three more times. Inhaling low. Carry the breath up to the top hand. Exhale both hands. Inhale low. Inhale high. Exhale both. One more time. Inhale low. Inhale high. Exhale both. Good. So now we're going to really think about that vertical sensation of our breath that we just started to develop. And we're going to try to add in a Kegel as we exhale. So your Kegel is when you contract the muscles that stop you from peeing. So that's what we want to engage on the beginning of our exhale. So if you want, you can take your yoga block and put it between your inner thighs, and this will help to just get a little bit more of that pelvic floor and those Kegel muscles to engage as you exhale. So here we go. We're going to inhale, travel the breath way down toward your pelvic floor, and then exhale, Kegel, pull the contraction up as you release the air. Again, inhale. Releasing your pelvic floor, and exhale, Kegel, squeeze that contraction up toward your chest. Good, again, inhale, and exhale, Kegel, contract, pulls up. Let's do three more rounds of that. Inhale, big breath in. Exhale. Two more times, and really feel free to squeeze that yoga block as you exhale. Good, last one, inhale. And exhale. Nice, my friend. So now we're gonna add the pelvic tilt into this as we exhale. So as you inhale, you'll fill your breath up down low into your pelvic floor again. Inhale. And then exhale, contract and posteriorly tilt, drawing your tailbone away from the ground, feeling your sacrum ground into the floor. Inhale, release the pelvic tilt. Exhale, contract. Tilt your tailbone up away from the ground. Glutes can engage. Inner thighs really squeeze. Good. Again, inhale. Exhale. Let's do three more of those. Inhale. Exhale. Last one. Good. We're going to do one more. This time you're going to hold the posterior tilt. So exhale, squeeze your Kegel muscles posteriorly. Tilt your pelvis away from the floor. Good. Now start to press down through your feet. And we're going to try to go vertebrae by vertebrae away from the ground, keeping those muscles all engaged and keeping the posterior tilt of your pelvis. Now we're extending our hips with it up toward the ceiling. Good. You're going to get up to your fullest hip extension that you can. Really squeeze and engage your glute muscles. Squeeze the yoga block if you have it between your knees. Good. Hold here for another breath. Try to press down through your feet a little bit firmer. Good. Take one more inhale. And now keep your glutes engaged, your posterior tilt, and slowly come down vertebrae by vertebrae from your upper spine. All the way down, each vertebrae has its own moment to press down into the floor. So you're maintaining that posterior pelvic tilt until the very last moment, sacrum grounds into the floor and tailbone reaches down. Good. We're going to do that one more time. Take an inhale. Exhale, posteriorly tilt, squeeze, and engage your Kegel muscles. Start to peel away from your spine or from the floor with your spine, pressing down through your feet, bridging up slowly, going vertebrae by vertebrae into your fullest hip extension, maintaining that posterior pelvic tilt. Keep the rib cage pulled in. Good. Holding here in your glute extension, your hip extension, your glute bridge. Keep engaging your Kegel muscles. Keep trying to posteriorly tilt your tailbone. So drawing that tailbone away from the floor. Take one more breath here. Can you push down through your feet a little more firmly? Can you squeeze and engage your glutes a little tighter? Good. And now vertebrae by vertebrae coming down. So you need to keep your glutes, your hamstrings engaged to maintain that posterior pelvic tilt. Try to really go piece by piece of your spine all the way back down to the floor. Posteriorly tilt even more as you get to your low back. Keep your glutes engaged until the very last moment. Tailbone releases down. Good. And relax. Nice. Okay. From here, my friends, we're going to come up onto hands and knees. So go ahead, take the yoga block out. Just place it over to the side. And now we're going to go into some pelvic tilts in a tall kneeling position, really trying to focus on our abdominal engagement to draw our pelvis into that posterior tilt. So you're going to start just in this tall kneeling position with your toes curled under toward your shins. You're going to first just place your hands on your pelvis, the sides of your hips. And now I want you to find an anterior tilt of your pelvis by sending your tailbone back behind you, releasing your lower abs, and thinking like you're trying to make the biggest butt possible behind you in space. Good. Now on your exhale, draw your tailbone down and draw your lower abs into engagement to pull yourself into that posterior pelvic tilt. Good. Again, inhale. Releasing anterior tilt. Exhale. Draw that tailbone down. Lower abs engage. Posterior pelvic tilt. Let's do that three more times, just moving with your breath. Inhale. And exhale. And just notice how everything comes into alignment as you posteriorly tilt your pelvis, drawing that tailbone down. Your knees are below your hips, rib cage is above your hips, shoulders above your rib cage. Good. And one more time, inhale, anteriorly tilt, and posteriorly tilt. Good. Awesome. Go ahead, relax. Now we're going to do that same thing, but in a kneeling plank. So this is going to feel pretty challenging for your abs. Even though we have the support of the knees on the ground, we're going to walk the knees back a little bit behind our hips, reach our sternum forward, bringing our shoulders right above the wrists, and lengthening our upper spine. So we're in T-spine extension, but the rib cage is not flaring open toward the floor. We're pulling the rib cage in and up, sternum reaches forward. Now from here, I want you to anteriorly tilt your pelvis, lengthen your hamstrings, drawing your tailbone up behind you in space. Take an inhale, and then exhale, posteriorly tilt your pelvis, drawing that tailbone down toward your hamstrings, using your lower abs to pull yourself into a posterior tilt, and you'll find that your abs really start to tremble there as you pull them in and back. Good, hold for a breath. Keep pushing out of the floor. Lift your knees a little bit off the ground and hold. Take an inhale. Exhale, set the knees down. Anteriorly tilt. Good. Exhale, posterior tilt. Hold here, drawing that tailbone down, lower abs into engagement. Can you curl the toes under still and lift your knees off the ground? Hold, nothing else changes in the body. You're in a tall plank now. Good, knees come down. Anterior tilt. Exhale, posterior tilt. Good. Keep the posterior tilt. Lift the knees. Hold. Keep pushing out of the floor. Lower the knees. And anterior tilt, shift back. Take a child's pose and breathe.
Good. Just take two more breaths here in child's pose. Inhale through the nose. Exhale through the mouth. Good, my friends.
We're going to do one more thing in this circuit. We're going to come down onto our stomachs and do a hip extension isometric. So from here, you're going to place your hands underneath your forehead. Elbows are to the sides of your shoulders. Now from here, you're going to keep one leg straight on the mat. You're going to bend the opposite knee, squeezing your calf in toward your hamstring. Now try to posteriorly tilt your pelvis, dropping your tailbone down toward the floor, using your lower abs to pull you into that posterior tilt. Rib cage stays pulled in. And now try to lift the knee off the ground without letting your tailbone reach up toward the ceiling. So keep drawing your tailbone down. Keep squeezing your calf in toward your hamstring. Good. Keep trying to lift. It probably won't get very high. You want to keep your hips and pelvis grounded into the floor. We're working pure hip extension here, so it's just your hamstring really firing up. Lower abs should be engaged. Take two more breaths. Good, and release. Go ahead, lengthen that leg. We'll switch sides, drawing your opposite heel to your butt cheek. Take a moment to draw your tailbone down toward the floor. Lower abs pull in and up away from the ground, and then try to lift your heel up toward the ceiling and hold. If you're feeling like you can lift your leg really high, try dropping your tailbone down even more, keeping the posterior tilt of your pelvis and going for pure hip extension rather than anterior tilt of your pelvis or spinal extension. Breathe. Take two more breaths. Keep squeezing your calf in toward your hamstring. Keep pushing that heel up. One more inhale. And exhale, release. Nice. Okay. Go ahead and just come up out of that position, my friends. Hopefully that all felt really nice. If you're feeling any sort of pain in your low back, it might be that on the ground, once you start to kick one heel back, you're going into spinal extension and releasing your stomach and your rib cage into the floor. You want to try to be in this position as much as possible, lying flat on the ground, keeping the glutes and tailbone reaching down toward the floor so we're not letting that booty reach up and back. It's pretty challenging to do in that position. Okay, next, grab your yoga block again. We're going to come down onto our backs and go back into the glute bridge. So from here, put the yoga block between your inner thighs. Feet flat on the floor. You're going to take your hands to your pelvis if you'd like again, or you can just have your hands on the ground this time. And you're going to take an inhale. Exhale, posterior tilt. Good. This time we're going to press down through the feet, bridge the hips up right away, not taking as much time to segment through the spine, but finding your fullest hip extension with the posterior tilt of your pelvis, squeezing the yoga block. Good, and we're holding here 30 seconds. So we're working our active hip extension. We're trying to maintain the posterior tilt, so try not to anterior tilt. Draw that tailbone up away from the ground. Good, guys, 15 seconds left. Keep pressing down through both feet. You can also drag your heels back toward you. That'll fire up your hamstrings even more. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and lower your hips all the way down. Release your posterior tilt. Nice. All right, next, we're gonna come up into the tall kneeling position. And we're just going to work that pelvic tilt a little bit more. So curl your toes under. Anterior tilt on your inhale. Exhale, posterior tilt. Good. Just try to feel out your lower abs as you posterior tilt. They're really working to draw that tailbone down toward the ground and lengthen the front of your hips. Inhale. Exhale. Two more. Inhale. Exhale. Last one. Inhale. Exhale. Good. Now we're going to come down onto hands and knees, walking the knees back behind you so you're in an inclined plank with your toes curled under. Okay? Reach your sternum forward. Try to have a straight line from your knees all the way to your shoulders. Now from here, you're going to anterior tilt your pelvis. Take an inhale. Exhale, posterior tilt as much as you can, drawing your tailbone down, finding hip extension. Then lift your knees, hold in your high plank for two breaths. Keep actively pushing out of the floor, use your lower abs, find those trembles of truth. Good, lower the knees down, and anterior tilt. Stick that booty up. Exhale, posterior tilt. Good, tailbone is dropped down. Now lift the knees. Good, you can straighten your legs all the way, but keep the tailbone dropping down in that posterior tilt. Keep pushing out of your shoulders, hold. And lower the knees. One more time, anterior tilt. Posterior tilt. Draw those lower abs in. Find that posterior pelvic tilt as much as you can. Lift the knees and hold. You're extending your hips fully, but you're using your lower abs to control it. One more inhale. Exhale, lower the knees. Release the tilt. Send your hips back to your heels. And just take two breaths in child pose. One more inhale. Exhale. Good. Now walk all the way forward. Come down onto your stomach. And now we have our isometric hip extension here. Making sure that we're not in this position when we lift our knee, right? Because I can lift my knee super high off the ground if I release my posterior pelvic tilt. So I want you guys to really find that posterior tilt, drawing your tailbone down toward the floor, using your lower abs to brace. Keep everything grounded. Then squeeze one heel to your butt cheek. Good. Then try to lift your knee. Try to get even just a few millimeters of space between your knee and the floor. Keep dropping that tailbone down. Hold. Can you squeeze your calf in toward your hamstring a little more? Use your lower abs. Keep pulling that tailbone toward the ground. One more breath. And lower it down. Other side. Squeeze your opposite heel to your butt cheek. Drop your tailbone down. Really find a posterior tilt. Lower abs pull in and up. Then try to lift your heel up toward the sky. Maybe the knee can lift off the ground. But most of your thigh should still be on the ground if you're in a true posterior tilt of your pelvis. Good. Three more breaths. Keep squeezing that calf in toward your hamstring. Last breath. And lower down. Good. Nice. All right. We're just going to take a little quick water break, my friends. I'm just going to make sure if there's any questions that they get answered. Awesome. Cool. I don't see any questions. Awesome to see you guys. Okay, cool. No questions on Zoom. Awesome. All right. So next,
we're going to go into a standing deadlift variation, and we're going to use the yoga block underneath one foot. So if you don't have a yoga block, try to find a thick book or a small object that you can put your foot onto. Okay. So go ahead, and we're going to set up standing. We're going to put the yoga block behind our front leg, and our back foot is going to be on top of the yoga block like this. Okay? And it's a relatively short stance, so just make sure that your back knee is only slightly behind your front leg. There's not a ton of space between your legs. Okay, and now we're going to work on maintaining a posterior tilt as we hip hinge. So a hip hinge is bringing our hips behind us in space as we lower our chest forward, and we keep a vertical shin of our front leg rather than a squat, which would be more like this, where our knee goes forward and our hips are generally going more straight down toward the floor. So for our hip hinge, we're working hip flexion as we hinge. And then we're really working hip extension and the power of that hip extension and that pelvic tilt to draw us into a tall standing position. So that's what we're going to focus on. The back foot is elevated just so we can get a little more weight shifted into the front leg. But if you need to do this with your back foot just on the floor, you can do that as well. Okay? So you'll just have the back heel popped up off the ground if your foot's on the floor. So from here, just take a moment to square yourself off to where you're facing, making sure that your hips are aligned facing forward. Your front leg's hand is going to go on the side of your hip. Opposite hand is going to reach toward your front toes as you hip hinge. Now just take a moment to find your posterior pelvic tilt, drawing your tailbone down. Then try to maintain that posterior tilt and your lower ab engagement as you shift your hips back in space, reaching your hands toward your opposite foot. Then exhale, push down through that foot, stand all the way up. Good. And we have 7 more reps. Inhaling in that hip hinge, exhaling, use your lower abs to draw your tailbone down. Good. 6 more, guys. Inhale. And exhale. And can you notice how your front leg's hamstring is lengthening as you send your hips back? And it contracts as you extend your hips and stand tall. Good. 4 more. Inhale. And exhale. We're going for sensations of the hamstring in class. So just try to make sure you're feeling out your hamstring. Good. 2 more. Last one. Inhale. Exhale. Good. All right, we're going to switch sides. So just shift your yoga block over a little bit if you need to. Okay, and we have 8 reps on this side. Just trying to go for that hamstring sensation, posterior pelvic tilt at the top. So try to make sure you're not in this position when you're standing. You're in this position with your tailbone drawing down, lower abs are engaged. Now take your front leg's hand, place it on the side of your hip, opposite hand. It's going to reach toward your front toes. Posterior tilt, and then start to inhale, sending your tailbone back. And exhale, push down through your front foot. Posterior tilt at the top even more. Inhale. And exhale. Good. 6 more reps. Take your time to move with your breath. We're going for that lengthen your front leg's hamstring as you hinge. And the hip extension as you stand all the way at the top. Notice how the pelvic orientation stays the same. We're trying to maintain a posterior pelvic tilt as we hinge and as we stand. Four more. Last two. Inhale. Exhale. Find those lower abs. Last one. Inhale. And exhale. Nice. Awesome. Go ahead, just move the yoga block off to the side. Next, we're going to do a standing hamstring curl. So this requires a little bit of balance, but if you need to, you can place your hand. If this was a chair or a couch, I would place my hand on top just to help me with balance a little bit. But if you can, we can do it without any objects and we can just balance on one leg. So what we're going to do is have one foot forward, then we're going to get into a little hip hinge, reaching the opposite foot back. So it's like a very small single leg deadlift. We're going to try to posterior tilt our pelvis even more, drawing the lower abs down or drawing the lower abs in, tailbone down toward our back hamstring. Now from here, I'm going to try to really kick my heel up and back using that hamstring, but don't let your tailbone reach up behind you. Posterior tilt. Then we're going to do 10 reps, curling that heel toward the butt, slowly lengthening the leg. Try to maintain your position as you maintain the hip extension of your back leg. Your front leg's knee is bent a little bit. And like I said, you can hold on to something here just to help you with the balance aspect. But we don't need to lift the leg very high to find the hamstring engagement and find our lower abs engaged to maintain our posterior pelvic tilt. We have four more reps. Squeeze that calf in as tightly into your hamstring as you can. Good, two more. Can you feel out that hamstring as much as possible? Good, push to stand. Woo! And we'll do the other side. I'll turn around for the other side so you guys can see that hip. And just know your standing leg's glute is also doing a lot of work to stabilize, especially if you're not holding onto an object for balance. So you'll probably feel that glute engage a lot. Okay, shift your weight into your opposite leg. Start to reach the opposite heel behind you. Keep your pelvis square to the ground. Try to maintain a posterior pelvic tilt. Then try to lift your leg up as high as you can. So really keeping the lower abs engaged, tailbone dropping down. Now exhale, squeeze that heel to your butt. Inhale, lengthen the leg, but try not to let the leg drift down toward the floor. You want to maintain the same height for your leg the entire time. So my femur, my thigh, isn't really moving at all. I'm just hinging at my knee. So if you feel like your leg is going up and down as you kick your heel to your butt, try to maintain the height of your leg. You'll feel more hamstring engagement. We have four more reps. Keep that tailbone dropping down. Lower abs engage as much as possible. Two more. Last one. And push to stand. Woo! Okay, guys, cool. Last thing in the circuit, we're gonna come down into tabletop on hands and knees, and we're gonna do a bird dog isometric, holding the hip extension of the back leg and our posterior pelvic tilt. We want to go for abdominal sensations and hamstring sensations in this exercise. So really try to maintain your abdominal engagement, holding like you would in a plank, and try to keep the tailbone dropping down. So you're going to be on hands and knees. Curl the toes under toward your shins. Let's lengthen one leg back behind us. First, just starting with the toes on the ground. Now find your posterior pelvic tilt as much as you can, drawing that tailbone down toward the floor. Then we're going to lift the leg. Probably feels very familiar because it's what we've been doing all throughout class. And we just did a standing variation of this, but now we're going to hold the leg straight, trying to maintain the height, reach the opposite arm forward, and hold. Notice if it feels really easy to lift your leg up high, that's because your tailbone is going up toward the sky. So draw your tailbone down, lower abs, pull into engagement as much as you can. Good. Keep holding here, keep extending out through your body. We have 10 more seconds. Can you feel out that back leg's hamstring as much as you can? And 3, 2, 1, lower down. Nice. I'm just going to switch to the other side. Take a moment. Curl the toes under. Set your position. Opposite leg goes back. Posterior pelvic tilt as much as you can. Lower abs engage. Then lift your back leg. Hold. Now try to keep that tailbone really dropping down as you hold the leg up, but keep fighting for height without compensating your position. Then lift your opposite arm up, and we're holding here 20 more seconds. Good. Again, going for abdominal and hamstring sensations. So it doesn't matter how high you lift the leg, can you go for what it feels like to keep that posterior tilt with your hip extension? 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and rest everything down. Nice.
Awesome job, guys.
Cool. We're going to go through that circuit again. I'm just going to grab a sip of water. This time we'll move just a little bit faster. Won't explain as much detail as we move through this, but we're going to move through the same circuit just a little bit faster pace, but still trying to maintain as much hamstring sensations throughout all the exercises as possible. Okay, so we're starting with the standing leg in front, back leg on the yoga block for the deadlift variation or hip hinge. So front leg is just about maybe like a foot and a half in front of the yoga block. Back foot is on top with the heel popped up. So you're just on the ball of your back foot. Now just make sure your hips are squared off to where you're facing. Front leg's hand is going to go on your pelvis. Opposite hand is reaching toward your front foot. Here we go. Posterior tilt. Inhale as you descend, reaching your hips back. And exhale, stand. 7 more reps, going for that hamstring length as you hinge. Exhale, hip extension. Inhale, keeping those lower abs engaged as you hinge and really drawing them in as you stand. 5 more reps. Good. 3 more. Last one. Awesome. Okay, we're going to switch sides. Go ahead, set up. Shift your body over a little bit. Get that opposite foot onto your yoga block or your book. Tailbone drops down. Opposite hand reaching toward your front foot here as you hinge. Inhale as you descend. Exhale as you stand. Oop, hold on one moment. All right. Sorry, guys, if you lost me. Okay. Here we go. Let's start this set over on this side. Here we go. Going into that posterior tilt and begin. Inhale, descending, sending your butt back. Exhale as you push to stand. Inhale. Exhale. Five more. See if you can lengthen your hamstring as you hinge, and then contract it as you stand. Really going for the sensations. Again, trying to feel out the hamstring and the lower abs. Three more. Last one. And rest. Nice. Okay, just to move the yoga block off to the side, we have the standing hamstring curl. So, shifting your weight into one leg, it's basically a mini single leg deadlift. So, you don't need to go far into a hip hinge, but soften into your front leg's knee. And start to shift weight into that leg, reaching the opposite heel back. Now pause here, posteriorly tilt your pelvis as much as you can. So draw those lower abs in, tailbone down. Maintain that as you try to lift your leg a little higher, and then exhale as you squeeze your hamstring or your calf into your hamstring. Good. We have 9 more reps. Exhale. Trying to just maintain the position with your body. And go for that hamstring curl. Can you keep dropping your tailbone down, but try to lift your leg up higher and maybe get onto the verge of feeling that hamstring start to cramp up a little bit as you squeeze your calf in. Good, we have 5 more reps, my friends. Again, feel free to hold on to an object. Your front leg's butt cheek, the standing leg, really has to work here to balance. Keep those lower abs engaged. You can give yourself tactile feedback by placing a hand on your lower abdominals. 2 more. Last one. Good. Stand and rest. Nice. We're going to go to the other side. Woo. Okay. Yeah, the benefit of this exercise is everything has to work. And we're just really focusing on that hamstring, but everything in your body is working. So don't worry if this feels really challenging. It's supposed to. Okay. Shift your weight into the opposite leg. Get into your little hip hinge, reaching the opposite leg behind you. Posteriorly tilt as much as you can, drawing your tailbone down, lower abs into engagement. Then try to lift through that hamstring a little bit more. Then exhale, squeeze calf into your hamstring and lengthen it out slowly. Again, we're trying to maintain the height of our back leg as we posteriorly tilt. And as we bend and hinge at the knee. So if you're feeling like your leg is moving around a lot, maybe just lower it a little bit and go for that hamstring sensation rather than the height. 5 more. Oof. Standing legs, booty cheek might be on fire. Try to keep breathing. We got 3 more reps. Good, last one. Lengthen out and push to stand. Woo! All right, come back down onto hands and knees, my friends. We're almost done with this circuit. We have just the bird dog, and then we'll start to just go into some dynamic stretches. Okay, so Bring your hands underneath your shoulders, knees underneath your hips to start, and then lengthen one leg straight back behind you. Okay, try to really find a solid base of foundation for yourself for this posture. So posteriorly tilt your pelvis, drawing your lower abs into engagement here. Then you're going to lift the back leg up off the ground, and we're going to hold here 30 seconds. You have the option to lift the opposite hand up and forward, but notice if that alters your spinal alignment or your pelvic alignment. Try not to compensate to lift the arm or leg higher. Keep lengthening out, but dropping your tailbone down. 15 seconds left. Keep reaching out. Find that hamstring as much as you can. And 4, 3, 2, 1. Lower down. Rest. Good. And we have the opposite side. Here we go. Other leg goes back. Try to find your solid foundation first. Really dropping your tailbone down. Find those lower abs. Good. Then lift the back leg. Hold. Can you feel out your hamstring? Then maybe lift the opposite arm forward. Can you drop your tailbone down even more? Pull those lower abs into even more engagement. Kick out through your heel and try to lift that leg higher. Good, 12 seconds left. Breathe. 3, 2, 1, rest. Nice. All right, guys, I'm just gonna grab a sip of water. Yeah. Okay, we're just gonna go into some dynamic stretches to cool down, and then we will finish up with some breath work. Okay. So let's start in a shin box position. We're gonna do some shin box rotations. So you're gonna face to the side of your mat with your front legs, foot pretty close to your back knee, and then your back knee is basically a little bit in front of your back hip, and your back foot is behind you, pretty close to your bum, okay? Now you can do this with your hands on the ground behind you if you'd like, and that's just a modification. If your hips are feeling a little bit tight today and you wanna just focus on the rotation, you're gonna rotate through your hips. We're gonna press up onto the shin and extend the hips fully, okay? You can keep the hands on the ground behind you as you rotate, or you can keep your hands at your chest as we rotate side to side. Exhale as you get into your fullest hip extension, squeezing your glutes at the top. Try to maintain good posture with your spine as you rotate through center. Exhale. Inhale. Good. We'll do a few more side to side. Feel free to move at your own pace. Feel free to use those hands on the ground behind you. Finding that nice posterior pelvic tilt at the top, just like we've been working on throughout class. We've got one more side to side. Good. Last one, getting to the original side, full hip extension. Good, and rest. Nice. So now we're going to shift this shin box position into what we call the 90-90 position. So now your legs are going to try to make 90 degree angles. You can walk your back hand a little bit further behind you and incline your spine back a little bit if you need to. So I want you to try to get your front leg's ankle in line with your knee, which is in line with your front hip. And then same with the back leg. Knee and hip are at a 90 degree angle, and the ankle and the knee are at a 90 degree angle. Now you're gonna put both hands behind you And we're just going to look at this back leg, and I want you to lift the heel up off the floor so you're on your big toe. Then you're going to externally rotate through that back hip and start to bring that heel, swivel it underneath your ankle. Now notice my other leg didn't move at all. If it needed to, that's okay, but try to maintain the original front leg down into the ground. Then once you get your hip open and rotated this way as much as you can without lifting this knee up, then you're going to slowly start to transition onto both sit bones and getting into what we call the bear sit position. And you can feel free to adjust your hips a little bit if you need to center yourself. Good. Now hold here in bear sit, reaching your chest open, trying to spread your knees as wide as possible. And then from here, we're going to transition to get to the other side of our 90-90. So I'm going to start to drop my new front leg down toward the floor, lifting the back heel and swiveling on the big toe, bringing this knee all the way down, and now I'm internally rotated in my new back leg. Okay, we're going to do one more time, just going the opposite way. Try to keep this new front leg grounded into the floor as much as you can. Walk your hands behind you, lift up your back heel's foot, or the foot, the back foot's heel, there we go, and now swivel on that big toe, externally rotating your back hip. Can you swivel the heel underneath you and then start to lift up that new front leg and then come into your bear sit? Good. Take a moment here to try to sit up as tall as you can, driving your knees down and apart from one another, and then slowly start to transition onto the original front leg where we started. Bringing that knee down, then lift your back heel up, swivel on that big toe, internally rotating through your hip, and coming back into the 90-90 position where we started. Nice. Good job, guys. Okay, let's just come back onto our spines. We're going to lay flat on our backs for a moment, pulling one knee into our chest, reaching the opposite leg out. So now we're in hip extension of the straight leg and hip flexion of the bent leg. Can you try to find a slight posterior tilt of your pelvis here? So engage your straight leg's glute, drawing your tailbone away from the floor, pulling your lower abs in and down. Good. Take a breath. Now we're going to interlace our hands behind our bent leg and interlace them on the hamstring, and now slowly straighten out your top leg as far as you can, keeping your knee as close to your chest as possible, and slowly bend. Good. So we're just trying to find an active length of the hamstring, which we worked out pretty well during this class. So just making sure we're actively lengthening it after we did all those contractions. Let's do just one more, slowly driving the heel up and bringing the heel back to your butt cheek. Good. And let's switch sides, pulling the opposite knee in, reaching the leg straight on the floor. You're going to try to keep that leg nice and straight and squeeze that straight leg's butt cheek to posteriorly tilt your pelvis slightly, drawing your tailbone slightly away from the ground. Take another breath here, pulling the knee as close as you can toward your chest. And then let's interlace our hands behind our bent leg's hamstring. Good. And now slowly lengthening. Try to get the leg as straight as you can without letting your leg drift away from your body. But it's wherever you can find an active stretch. So again, we're going for the sensations, trying to really get the mind to connect to how the stretch feels. Good, just one more. And slowly bend. Good, from here, let's just pull both knees into our chest for a moment. Give ourselves a little rock side to side. Good, and then rock forward and back along your spine. And do it a few times if that feels good. And then come up to a tall seat. Nice. We're just going to finish with two rounds of some slow breathing. So sit however feels comfortable for you. And then you can close your eyes. Notice your posture. See if you can sit up a little taller, grounding your sit bones into the floor. Take an inhale through your nose. Exhale through your mouth. And one more like that. Inhale. Exhale. And now we're going to inhale for 1, 2, 3. Exhale. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Inhale. 1, 2, 3. Exhale. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. One more time. Inhale. 1, 2, 3. Exhale. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Awesome. Go ahead. Just come back to your natural rhythm of your breath. And we are all set for today, my friends. Awesome work. Thanks so much for tuning in. My name's Hallie. I forgot to mention that at the beginning of class, but if you've never taken class with me before, thanks for joining in. And yeah, have an awesome rest of your day. See you guys next week.